You want to change your resolution for your game. But how to do it? In this video, I'll show you how. First, I create a new widget for basic main menu. I will be changing resolution and settings, and I want both widgets to have the same layout, so switching between them will feel consistent. Create new widget, or if you have similar main menu as I have, duplicate it. Name it WBP_settings and open it. We will use left vertical box with buttons. I edit image just to find balance of vertical box width and size of buttons. I just make a quick adjustment to the settings and now I show you how I have it. I have canvas panel inside of another one, so there is a gap between edges. Image with slightly different color as main menu has. Text block for headline settings. Vertical box for subcategories of settings. And horizontal box for options. Now you have two ways how to organize your options layout. If you use horizontal boxes, rows will be aligned, but you will have to align columns. If you use vertical boxes, columns will be aligned, but you will have to align rows. Which I choose because it seems easier to me. Add two vertical boxes. First one will contain text information and the second one interactable elements. Add two text blocks into the first vertical box. To the first one, change text to resolution colon space. To the second one, full screen colon space. Select both text blocks and change size to 32. Under padding, set bottom to 20, and I have set here right padding to 40, but it will be better to set it to vertical box in which those text blocks are. Now to the second vertical box. Drag into it horizontal box, and into it button, and into button text block. Drag into horizontal box another text block, and another button with text block, so it looks like this. Rename left button to btn_res_left. Change size to 32 and text to less than sign. Middle text block rename to tb_resolution. Check it as variable and change size to 32. Enter the right button, change text to greater than sign. Size to 32 and rename button to btn_res_right. I will also add left and right padding to the middle text block so it has some space from buttons. To the second vertical box, add button with text block. Set text size to 32, rename it to tb_fullscreen and check it as variable. Rename button to btn_fullscreen and change top padding of this button or bottom of the horizontal box above so it's in line with the information text on the left. To avoid resizing text all the time, I just copy fullscreen button, click the canvas and paste it. Change anchor to right bottom and both alignments to 1. Set position X and Y to -20. Change text to apply changes and rename button to btn_apply. Also adjust size of the main horizontal box so it doesn't collide with apply button. Click the canvas panel and paste last button. To this one, change anchor to top right and X alignment to 1. Position X will be -20, position Y just 20. And rename it to btn_exit. Change text to capital letter X and the background of button to dark color. I choose dark red. And that's all for visual part of widget. Now go to the graph. I don't know what type of monitor the player will have, so I want to find information about resolution. Drag out execution pin of event construct and type resolution. Out of all options here, get supported full screen resolution seems the best. We can see that this function returns an array of resolutions. So I quickly print out what it contains. Or not. I've restarted Unreal, but it looks like the default library haven't connected properly. If you come across the same issue in the future, just create a temporary actor which should have libraries connected properly, find the function, copy it, and paste it where it is missing. The libraries should then reconnect. Now I finally quickly print out resolution array. I also add the settings button in main menu functionality on clicked, which will create settings widget and edit the viewport. Because the main menu must always be opened first, I will also add functionalities to level blueprint. After begin play, create widget main menu, add the viewport, set input mode UI only, get player controller, and show mouse cursor. Hit compile and test it. Here you can see all supported resolutions, which seems alright. So close it and back to settings. Drag out resolution pane, promote it as variable and create new function, setup settings. After start place, get game user settings. Drag in a resolution and out of it search for each loop and connect it. Out of array element, select break int point. Right click and search for append under string category and add another pin. To the middle one write x, to the first one connect x and to the last one y. I created array resolutions.txt which will be text copy of resolutions array because this seems better to me. If you don't want second array, you will have to convert it by append every time you need text information. Drag in resolutions.txt and out of it select add. Connect it to loop body and connect into it append. After that, add branch. Create new variable current res index and change it to single integer. Drag TB resolution after branch and out of it search for set text, which will be set when branch will be true. Drag in set of current res index, which will have value of index currently added to resolution text and connect it. Now to the condition of branch. Out of get game user settings search for get screen resolution. Break it and only when x and y are the same, we got our current resolution with its index in array. Now I'll clean it up a bit. We also want to be able to change full screen. Out of get game user settings, search for get full screen mode. You can see that output pin is enumeration, so out of it search for switch on. Here you can see that we have three options. Create new variable full screen mode and change it to full screen's enumerator e window mode. Drag in its set, triplicate it, and because this is setup, change it to the same values. Drag in TB full screen and set its text appropriately as well. Go to event graph and add call to our setup settings function to event construct. Hit compile and when you play, you can see that the initial text is set up correctly. Now finally to the changes themselves. First, we implement functionalities for changing resolutions. To the buttons res left and res right, add event on clicked. Both functionalities will be similar, so we can implement it simultaneously. When we click on a button, it must know if it can do what it should do. so add branches. Resolutions are sorted in ascending order, so we can go left in array when current resolution index is above 0. We can go right when we haven't reached last index yet, current resolution index is lower than last index. When those conditions are true, we can still move to the edge points of array. Decrement index for moving to the left, increment it for moving to the right, and set those values as new values of current res index. When it's done, drag in TB fullscreen, search for set text, which will be same for both functions. Get text of current selected resolution and connect it to set text. Out of set text, get game user settings. Get regular resolution we have currently selected. Search for set screen resolution. Connect it and that's it. Now to the full screen. Select full screen button and add on click event. We will use same approach as in setup function, so go into it. Copy all connected from switch on and paste it after to the event. Switch will work according to our full screen mode variable. I put game mode user settings at the beginning, but you can place it later if you feel it will look better. Disconnect all execution pins out of switch on. Select top sets, move them down and reconnect it from top to bottom. Out of get game user settings, search for set full screen mode and place it after set text. In full screen mode, connect with full screen mode variable. Connect all set text into set full screen mode and that's it. Now add on click function to apply button. Get game user settings and on apply button you need apply settings. Here you have one option to check. Check for command line overrides. This allows you to override settings with command line in shipped game but not in editor. If you go to Edit and Editor Preferences, under Level Editor, select Play, and this will override your viewport settings even if you select Standalone Game, so uncheck it. Apply Settings note will also save your settings in your shipped game, which is nice. Now, add on click function to exit button. Again, get game user settings and search for reset the current settings. Because if I close settings menu, I want it to have current settings when I open it up again. To the end, add remove from parent, which will destroy this widget. Before testing and final tips, this video was sponsored by me. I put a lot of time to make this video. So hit the like button and subscribe if this video was helpful and you want to see more. You can see that changing the resolution works. If this would be the final product, now I know I have to change anchors and probably more things so it would be more responsive. Windowed full screen will also change to the highest resolution, but I guess this is how it should work. If you want to continue building your settings menu, go check Unreal documentation page for settings, where you can see a list of all kinds of settings you can implement. That's all from me, and if you want to learn more about Unreal Engine, definitely check another video right here. Thanks for watching.